Saber 27. I'll be playing this game for you today. Let's get started on it. Just a heads up, I'm also gonna throw some names out there. There's some people that I watched and I like a lot too, which are basically Danny and Aaron from the Game Grumps, Vash, the Rad Brad, and there's a few others as well out there. If y'all watch my videos, you may see them in my subscriptions, and there's also the Best Friends Play as well. I like watching a lot of their stuff. This is the reason why they get me into it. We're gonna get into this game today, and also another thing, I do have the DLC content as well with this game, and I will be doing those and getting the extra costumes, and from time to time I will most likely be switching them up, and I'll be running around in the alternate costumes that you can get for the character. Let's jump right into a new game. Just an FYI, I do also have a couple of other saved files as well. Don't really be worried about that. This is just there. I mean, you turn this down a bit. Yeah, the system has a wheel toy control on the controller, so I can just... Come on. That's better. Let me fall. There's another way. Oh, the cutscene says... best I could. I do love this game so much. I played the Vita version a long time ago, and it's a very fun game because it's so innovative and so interesting, because you free scale the city and you do all this stuff to make you, to improve your reputation and become a hero, and just the story is just grand and beautiful. Let's learn. Let's lead us into tutorial mode. Another one of my favorite characters. Yeah, this is one of the funnest games ever. And this is also another reason why I picked this to be my first LP ever. Because this is a... because it's a very fun game. It's not really that long, per se. It's a little long, but it's not that long. So, man, I can knock out a lot of it in no time. I'm going to try to knock out as many as I can today. Many missions today. Chapters and side missions and stuff like that today as I can. And there's our mystery girl. Who we play. I'm not gonna read this stuff because it's like, what are you doing here? Are you lost too? Well, I don't mind giving you, I don't have anything to give you, so run along and find somewhere else to beg. I may not read that stuff and let y'all read it yourself. Because I'm lazy like that some days. And they also did set it up in a comic book style panel system too. And it's done, it's a shell-shaded, looks like it's a shell-shaded comic style action-adventure game. Episode 1 from Oblivion. As you can see, it's from a comic book system. Think about it. Camera control first person. They start teaching you things. This is basically tutorial stuff here. Boring, but also fun. I'm sorry about the whole first part of this. This is just... I'm so sorry about this. This whole first part of the game is just so... It's just so boring and... Like, that whole part right there is just so boring and everything like that, because it's just... basic tutorial stuff, and they're just making you go through it. And this is also the only time in the game I believe that you'll have an infinite gravity bar. I can't remember if there's any other times that you'll have it, but... but you can get it set up later to, you can get it set up later to, where it's, like, long-lasting and everything like that, but... talking about another character that will come into play in a little while. She's the one doing this. And that cat. You see, that cat's gonna play in a very important role. See? Okay, it has a very important role, and it's just... and I'm not doing any of this. I'm not... this right here is the only time you'll have an infinite gravity system. Which is very fun, because you're... not even controlling it. And there we go. Again. Where did they see the most of them? That's the gravity storm. Now I'm going to learn to do. Now I get to learn to do. Now I get to learn how to control, how to shift the gravity system. One more step, I gotta find the next step. Huh, can you gravity shift? I was able to. Yep. Okay. A fun tweak about this game. You can literally... the flow... yeah, this is all tutorial stuff, as you can see. boring tutorial stuff. I gotta find out where I'm at. I also have Bloodborne on my system as well. I may even play that, but I don't know if I'm gonna play the game campaign from start to finish, or I'm just gonna have a setup where I'm just gonna be going around just randomly fighting things. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it yet. I have a quick 16-second video on there, but I was just mainly just testing things. And there's also going to be another one of this game out here for like 25 seconds. That's just another test, see if it's truly, working or not. If I was truly getting it to work, and if my mic was going to work. And I just screwed up somehow. Big old hand later. Very later. Now you get to find one like it later. But I can't grab your stone. The chimp they call home. And this is where you're about to see a very bad thing happen to a good person. She's trying to stop it, but it's falling, and they just catch the wrong moment, and they look like she was pushing it off. And she didn't. Just trying to keep it from falling. And they're pissed. You could trust the gravity shifter, huh? Those two will come back into play several times throughout the game. She didn't, which is sad. The shifters are not bad people, it's just the people treat them like scum because they're not like them. And you're about to see something interesting. Nothing but the abyss. Chunk of the land is missing.
Bless you, you must fear.
Tripped out, man.
It's your core place of issue to one thing. Pleasure to do. Plans shall be meant to resolve points shall fail. The blessing man, the victory, shall plan to the survey.
Let's keep going on to chapter 2. Alright, go. Now you're auto saving. Yeah, follow Dusty. About to get the use of the gravity gauge. Catch the girl. And I outran the bird, didn't I? Now I got the gravity gauge in play. Turn to normal gravity. Love that building. Useful building. Going up there. And there she is. The only other shifter. That's another random thing you can do. Not right now. Now you get to learn combat. Yes, and the tutorial is not over yet. Shadow of the City, this is the second out of the tutorial. Basically, your first, I think your first three missions in this game, or your first three episodes, are just basic tutorial stuff. They're teaching you about, they're just basically teaching you about, combat, gravity controls, and a few minor other things. That's about it, and it's just some detailed stuff about the story. And we got Nevi. These things are annoying, but they're easy to fight. It's a bigger gravity side. Nope. We got no gravity side technique yet, but that will come into use for later, and that's a very fun technique to use. And my gravity went up. Oh, great. They're teaching you how to do all the combat situation stuff. Come on. There it goes. That's nothing. That's powerful. Not super. He's gonna have to take care of things. He also. He can't, he doesn't want to, the Nevi, and, he basically gave a set of, the remarks for what he did, even though that he told him everything that she did. he explained the situation. I don't think he told him about her just yet, but he will soon. Another tutorial mission. Another tutorial information. Go to the fountain. Don't get the gravity side. Not until up. Yes, in some cases, running through the city is better than shifting through the skies and stuff like that. For right now, it's better just to not really use the shifting power as much as possible, because my gravity gauge is, well, crap compared to my main file, to my main game that I've been playing, where it's doesn't burn down that fast and all that. So man, grab the precious gems floating in the air. And yeah, those gems come very useful. You need them to we need these to do a lot of things in the game. There's certain items in the game that are basically showing you the last of the tutorial stuff, which is basically they're gonna teach you. But yeah, there's a lot of tutorial stuff in this game, no matter what. But the game doesn't do that much hand holding. And my grab is refilled, so I can come over here. That's another flaw of her gravity fire tube. 7. Let's get up here. These things come very useful. They basically explain to you that they are your means of certain. You're gonna find these all. And deposit gems into the fountain. Yeah, that does happen a lot. Acquire at the fountain, trigger on the fountain. And most of these things are gonna cost you between. This is the only one that's gonna be the cheapest one you're ever gonna get, which is gonna be the 7 gems. Other than that, everything after that's gonna be like 10, 20, 30, or 40, I believe. Depending on where you're at. It's working, and now we got a side challenge that we can do, which that's how you unlock your side challenges and stuff like that, is by reactivating these devices. Now Kay can upgrade her powers. Let's go here. I can only upgrade one because everything else. I'm also gonna show you the different tabs we got here. We got the core powers, which is basically your gravity use, your gauge use, your health, your recovery time. Your recovery time is basically how long it takes for your gravity meter to recover. Your shifting speed is basically just like when you're falling or going through the air, you can go faster. Then you got your kicking, which is basically your ground combat, your gravity kick, your invasion, your slide kick. Which slide kick is very useful in certain cases because it's stronger than most things. And you get your powers, stasis field. You got stasis field, which is your gravity powers. Stasis field and gravity side, which gravity side will literally help a lot. It will get you around the city really fast and it will help with a lot of attacks. And you got your special powers, which these three will come into play later. Let's just upgrade the one gauge I can't upgrade right now, which is my gravity use. This will affect my gravity ability, which allow me to do things. This is one of the side challenges I can do, but I'm not gonna do it right now because I can do it, but I'm not going to do it right now because it's just I want to do it when I got more health and more gravity gauge. My combat to be a little bit my kicks and all that stuff, my gravity kick and all that stuff to be come on. There it goes. This woman basically tells me not to take this wrong, but they need she's telling you that you're basically dirty and you need to take a shower and all this stuff, and this basically is that's what's known as a rumor spot, and those things are useful because they explain and see on the map here you got this is the full city or real part of the city. There's a chunk of it missing still, and there's a chunk of it missing on it, and you need to retrieve it, but I can't retrieve it just yet. There's a certain build up to it. This is a challenge marker, room, it's on my rumor spot. Okay, check it out. I like trying to get most of the rumor spots if I can. Oh, I know what this rumor spot is. Don't know what this is. I gotta go all the way down. There's one more thing I need to... Ow. I gotta find this. Thus, it basically explained that she needs to find a place. Yeah, here we go. The park. I gotta come down here. Oh, she's not down here yet? Huh. She'll be down there by now. Maybe not. Oh well. Yeah, you come back. That place comes very important later again too. Several times. And I'm about to faceplant again. Try not to faceplant because too many times it's just bad. Every side. This is one of the fastest ways to get around the city. And without shifting too. She has some serious hair off that too, which is funny. Okay. Let's start the beginning of the mission. Need to find some place to take a hot shower, and down the sewers we go. This is basically unlocking our fast travel system. And this is actually very useful in the game. This becomes very, very good. Because I like using the fast travel stuff. It's just so easily done. It's creative, and it's interesting that they see that this is the main hub where all the sewers throughout the whole city of Huxville is connected. And you can get literally from one island to another somehow through a sewer pipe. But makes no sense, but it's kind of weird. And she founds her home. A sewer pipe. Now I gotta find furniture. Let's go find some stuff for the house. Alright. Not a normal mission without it. Not a normal mission without it. Having some type of trouble, right? Up we go. Alright. I'm gonna show me where they. See how bad that gravity slide kick is? That gravity kick is? Pretty brutal. It's a brutal item. It's a brutal ability. Because it usually, most of the time, just one hit sinks. Now they're teaching us about the stasis field. No, she thinks it's funny. This game, the only difference between this game and the Vita version is that you don't unlock Gravity Slide up until you go into this, until later on. You don't get it until later on. This game, they decided to, give it to you early enough so you can have access. Oh. Yeah, I'm not good with the gravity controls. Sorry about that. That's another reason why I don't really... Let's check our map and go to the rumor spot. Gotta go up. Only time that I really use my gravity powers is when I have to go up to higher scale areas. Am I gonna make it? Oh, yes, I did. Awesome. Alright. Not sure about that. We can take the get now. We got a desk, which rarely enough when you see this thing, you may wonder how is that a desk when it's more of a drawer. And over here, generate the stasis field, right? Desk kind of small. I'll take it. It's only three. It's like what makes it funny. You only have to collect three items, and you only have to collect three items, and look at this here, yes. And I'll get the sewer, come out here, and come out here. There's information over here, gotta go over here. I'm about to just gonna grab your side because and that. Okay. Okay. After when I get the house set up, I'll show you the extra costumes that I can unlock. And it's funny. There's two other costumes you can unlock in the game after you beat the game. They can be played in New Game Plus mode. But you have to go and. Yeah, not with the Navy Corps. Navy Corps are just basically that. Come on. Down. Oh, come on. And you just got me. Okay. That was not what I was trying to do. Oh, come on, dude. And then I gravity decided to just. time to go up. That's the last one. Now we get to bed. Yeah, there's the bed, and it's just right now just a frame, which makes no sense. And when you get it back to her place, it has a mattress on it, which is awkwardly funny. And yeah, you can kind of launch people. And I will be. Check right through the sewers. And there's the mattress on the bed, which makes no sense. Mattress, pillows, and covers, everything. Now it's time for the fun part. The cut scene that basically shows her collecting certain things. And her getting in trouble by the cops for not taking the candles. And she has everything she needs to take a shower. She gets cleaned up. And her place is all junked out, and her bed just collapsed on her. Now we got her home, so we can go and do safe functionings and stuff like that. Well, now I'm gonna show you what her house looks like. This is basically what her house looks like after when she cleaned it all out and fixed it up. She turned it into this. Costumes, we got the school uniform, we got the spy set, the maid costume, and the military outfit. The military outfit is going to be the last one I'm going to be trying to get. And there's also the maid costume, which I can get. That will be the next one after. I can get the maid costume after a certain point. Each of the side missions come into play later. I'm gonna save it anyway. I'm gonna save this right quick, and sorry if the screen goes blank. Alright, I'm back. I'm sorry about that. I just had to save my game, and that's about it. I think I may just call it here for right now, and I'll be back on later on to do a little bit more. I'll see y'all later. Bye.